And so what I would say is, look, just accept the fact that whoever you voted for, Kim said, I don't know if I voted for the right person. I don't know if I voted for the wrong person. I said, honey, I guarantee you that no matter who you voted for the wrong person. Like, right? Because no matter who you voted for, they're going to do some things that you wish they had not done. They're probably going to, whether, you know, whether it, be, it was Biden or Trump, there are probably some things, if you're honest, you'd go, oh, those are things I really hoped would happen. And then if you're honest, you go, wow, I don't want to be associated with that. We live in the privilege of bringing adjustment and correction to the direction of our government and our society. And here we are in a moment in history where you've had intense conversations about Black lives and dealing with the issues of systemic and cultural racism, dealing with the issues of injustice and police abuse. Do you realize that this is a nation whose narrative for Black society was slavery? And now you have Black leaders who are shaping the course of America's future. That by itself lets me know, no, we're not a nation that's buying its mythology of perfection. What's interesting is this is a nation that keeps rewriting its mythology and rewriting its story and saying the story of the past isn't adequate and we're going to keep rewriting it. And so I look at you and I go, you are the proof that we're getting better. And you are the promise that we can keep getting better.
I have a question. How do we lose well? Because I know when Trump won, there were so many people that protested his presidency. And I think what makes me more anxious is when we do know who wins, how the losing side will respond. I mean, Trump's been on Twitter saying he's gonna say this is fraud, he's gonna take legal action.
And he is doing all that.
He sets a culture of not knowing how to lose. How do we get to a place where we can lose well?
Yeah, it would be a great world if politicians could stand up and lose with dignity and with honor. I look back now to the Bush-Gore election, and you realize now, looking back, how much honor both Al Gore and George Bush had, because the nation was split. It was a thin slice election. Florida decided everything, and it could have gone either way. And you did not see Al Gore in any way.
He did not whine.
This affect the credibility of the American system. And I think we should look back and go, oh no, people have actually shown us what honor and dignity looks like when they lose.
Is that what's making us anxious? Because we're watching two people fight for power and right in front of our eyes?
Does it have to do with us being millennials and not knowing how to lose? Because everything has been given.
I think that your generation hasn't yet learned how to lose with honor and how to lose with dignity. And it's a part of what will help you win better when you go forward. Because what you'll find over time is that if you lose without honor, you will lose people who would commit to you, not because they disagree with your policies, but they agree with your character.
Watch it live on Hillsong Channel or head to HillsongChannelNow.com/McManus to watch it now.